Hey guys, in this video I'd like to talk about cardiac cycle. So before starting up with cardiac cycle, let's understand basic physiology, how signal initiates. So in every heartbeat, in every heart contraction, there is a role of SA node. When SA node triggers the signal, so signal travels from SA node to the atria. Yeah, so when it comes to atria, atria gets depolarized and undergoes contraction. So with that, our cardiac cycle starts, let's say. Okay, now let's define what is cardiac cycle. So it is a sequence of events which is happening in one heartbeat. So which includes two phases. One is systole, one is diastole. Systolic phase and diastolic phase. Okay, when I'm talking about systolic phase, when heart is contracting, when heart contracts, what will happen? Blood will be pumped into blood vessels such as pulmonary artery and the aorta. When we are talking about diastole, heart is under relaxation. So when heart is relaxing, what will happen? The blood will be filled into the ventricles, then it will be ready for the further systole. So every diastole, blood is filled into the ventricles, then it pumps further into the aorta and pulmonary artery. So this is a sequence of events which is happening in the cardiac cycle. So let's break it down and see what happens in each and every stage, right? So earlier I told you, signal starts from SA node, then it spreads through the atria. When it spread to atria, what will happen? Let's see. So this is our atria and ventricle. Okay, so whatever phases I am explaining in one side of the heart, same changes is happening in the other side of the heart. Now when I am telling mitral valve opens, in the other side tricuspid valve opens. When I am telling aortic valve opens, in the other side of the heart pulmonary valve is opening. So between both atria and ventricle, we have atrioventricular valve and we have semilunar valve. Now let's talk what happens when signal comes to atria. When signal comes to atria, what will happen? Atria undergoes depolarization, then atria further contracts. So we can call it as atrial systole. Atrial systole, are also called as atrial contraction. Okay, now let's see what happens. When atria contracts, it will push all the blood, whatever which is receiving from the pulmonary veins, into the left ventricle. So blood is being filled to the left ventricle. In the same sequence is happening in the other part of the heart when I am talking about right side. Okay, now in atrial systole, what is happening? Let's see. So atrial systole, atrioventricular valve is open, AV valves are open. Okay, what happens further? Atria contracts, blood is filled into the ventricle. Okay, at the same time, what is happening to the semilunar valves, that is aortic and our pulmonary valves? So aortic and pulmonary valves is closed, semilunar valves are closed. Okay, now atria undergone contraction, atria pumped blood from the atria to the ventricle. Now let's see how much quantity of blood which is pumped during atrial systole, which is approximately 20% of the blood. Okay, now let's see from where other 80% of the blood comes by the end of the video. Now let's remember, only 20% of the blood is filled during atrial systole. Okay, now when atria is undergoing systole, what is happening to the ventricle? So ventricle is still relaxing. Why ventricle is still relaxing? From atria, signal goes to where? To AV node. Okay, now when signal goes to AV node, what will happen? AV node has a special property which delay the signal. When signal is delayed there, so from AV node, signal didn't come to ventricle. So ventricle is under relaxation phase. So ventricle is under relaxation, that is ventricular diastole. Ventricular diastole. So these are the changes what happens during the atrial systole. So atrial systole, blood from the atria pumped to the ventricle. Now let's see what happens further. Okay. Now whatever signal which was stuck in the atrioventricular node, that is AV node, right, which will come further into the ventricles. So ventricles start to contract. When ventricles start to contract, what will happen? The blood will try to go back from ventricle to the atria. When blood tries to go back from ventricle to the atria, these atrioventricular walls will close. They will close. It won't allow blood to go back. Now what is happening? See, ventricle is contracting, right? Atrioventricular walls are closed. Same time, the semilunar walls are also closed, which is aortic and pulmonary valve. So what is happening? Ventricle is contracting. There is no change of volume of the blood inside the ventricle, but both walls are closed. We call it as isovolumetric contraction. Isovolumetric contraction. Okay, now what happened during isovolumetric contraction? Blood from the ventricle tried to go back. The atrioventricular valves are closed. Any time during our cardiac cycle, if valves are closing, there will be a heart sound. So during isovolumetric contraction, we have a first heart sound, that is S1. We hear first heart sound. What will happen? Atrioventricular valves closed. What else is happening? That is semilunar valves, they are also closed. Semilunar valves also closed. Okay. Now we call this phase as a isovolumetric contraction. So isovolumetric contraction, ventricle is contracting. Okay. Both valves are closed. So we call it as isovolumetric contraction because there is no change of volume. And because of closure of the atrioventricular valves, we have first heart sound, that is S1. So this is a change which is we can see during the isovolumetric contraction. Okay, now let's see what will happen after isovolumetric contraction. Okay, both valves were closed. Okay, what will happen? Ventricle is undergoing contraction. Ventricle was undergoing contraction during isovolumetric contraction. After isovolumetric contraction, what will happen? Let's see. Okay, now ventricle contracts further. What happens to the pressure inside the ventricle? Pressure inside the ventricle will be increased. When pressure inside the ventricle increase, what will happen? So let's see. For example, pressure inside the ventricle increases more than the pressure in the aorta. Pressure inside the ventricle increases more than aortic pressure. When pressure inside the ventricle increases more than the aorta, what will happen? This aortic valve open. In the same way, in the right part of the heart, our pulmonary valve open. When pulmonary valve is open, ventricle is under contraction. So what will happen? The blood from the ventricle will be ejected into the aorta, and the same thing is happening in the right side of the heart, which is from right ventricle blood is ejected into the pulmonary artery. So we call this phase as a ejection phase, ejection period. During ejection period, what is happening? Blood from the ventricles is pumped into the blood vessels, that is aorta and pulmonary artery. Why? Because the pressure inside the ventricle rises more than the pressure inside the aorta. That's how the valves open and the blood is pumped. We call this as ejection period. During ejection period, it is divided into slow ejection and rapid ejection. It's very simple that slow ejection is nothing but during ventricular contraction, whatever blood is going slowly, we call it as slow ejection fraction, slow ejection. When we are talking about rapid ejection, immediately after the contraction, as soon as valve open, whatever with this rapid force the blood is ejected into the aorta or pulmonary artery, we call it as rapid ejection period. Okay, now blood was inside the ventricles, So aortic and pulmonary valves opened. Okay. So blood from the ventricle entered into the blood vessel. So from right part it will go to lungs, from left part it will go to aorta and the throughout the body. Now let's see what happens after ejection period. Okay. After ejection period, during ejection period, blood had entered into our aorta and pulmonary artery, right? Now see what will happen. Whatever blood which was there in the aorta or pulmonary artery, it will try to come back. But the aortic valve and pulmonary valves will close. When valves close, we have a S2. Okay. When valves close, we have S2. That is due to closure of semilunar valves. Now, what is happening? Ventricle is undergoing diastole. Now, let's see what is happening. Ventricle is under diastole. Okay. Both valves are closed. Volume is not changed. We call this phase as isovolumetric relaxation. Okay. During isovolumetric relaxation, what is happening? Both valves are closed. Ventricle is under diastole. So this phase we call it as isovolumetric relaxation. Now, remember that first phase when I was talking about atrial systole. After atrial systole, atria was under diastole. So all these phases, atria was under diastole. What will happen? Pressure inside the atria increases. Why pressure inside the atria increases? Because the blood is filled into the atria from pulmonary veins as well as superior and inferior vena cava on the right side, from pulmonary veins on the left side. Now, let's see what happens in the next phase. Okay. After isovolumetric relaxation. So, next thing what is happening here is our aortic and pulmonary valves are closed. Yes. Our aortic and pulmonary valves are closed. Okay. Our atrioventricular valves were closed. What will happen? Throughout this time, atria was receiving blood from the pulmonary veins in the left side. So pressure inside the atria increases. When pressure inside the atria increases more than the left ventricle, this mitral valve opens. On the left side, when we are talking about right side, that is tricuspid valve. So this valve open, blood will fill into the ventricle. So now what are the changes we can see? Pressure inside the atria increase. Okay. Now what will happen? Opening of AV valves. Okay. So opening of AV valves. What is pressure inside the atria increase? Because of that, our AV valves opened. After AV valves opened, whatever blood was there inside the atria rapidly filled to the ventricle. Rapid filling of ventricle. We call this phase as rapid ventricular filling. Okay. So, rapid ventricular filling, this is the point of time where our rest 80% of the blood is received. Why? Because during atrial diastole, it was a long period of time which allowed blood to store in it in a large quantity and it just filled. Okay. Now let's see a patient who is having atrial fibrillation. When patient is having atrial fibrillation, atria is not contracting properly. Even though atria is not contracting properly, the patient won't have that life-threatening symptoms immediately. The only reason is the filling of ventricle majorly depend on the rapid ventricular filling but not on the ventricular systole. Okay. Now, after rapid ventricular filling, our SA0 fires the next signal and atria undergoes contraction, that is atrial systole, same cycle keeps on repeating. Okay. Now, after this, I want to talk about little bit about some volumes. So that is end systolic volume, end diastolic volume. Okay, end systolic volume, the quantity of blood which is remained in the ventricle after a systole, we call it as end systolic volume. So quantity of blood in ventricles after systole. Now we can already guess end diastolic volume. End diastolic volume, the quantity of blood in the ventricle, the quantity of blood in the ventricle after a diastole, we call it as end diastolic volume. So it is quite sensible that end diastolic volume is more than end systolic volume. End systolic volume. So based on this, we can calculate something called ejection fraction. Ejection fraction. Ejection fraction is very simple thing to understand. The fraction of blood which entered into the ventricle during rapid ejection period. During rapid ejection period gives us a ejection fraction. So normal ejection fraction is around 60-65% of the total blood in the ventricles. Total blood in the ventricles. No, so now it should be 65% of the end diastolic volume. 65% of the end diastolic volume is a normal ejection fraction. For example, 60% of end diastolic volume is a normal ejection fraction. So I mean to say, when 60%, 65%, so 60% of end diastolic volume should be pumped into the aorta. We call this as a ejection fraction. Keep following, guys. Thank you. This ends our cardiac cycle.